Hello everyone and welcome back to another Blender Made Easy tutorial. Today we're going to be looking at Blender 2.8 and what we're going to be looking at are the collections. Now collections basically replace groups and layers. Now how they work is they're over here on the right corner, and if I drop down this menu we can see what's in this collection. We can see that we have the cube right here, we have the camera and the lamp. Now from what I've noticed so far, collections are a lot more efficient and much easier to use than groups and a lot more organized. So how collections work is we just add in an object and it places it in that collection that we have selected. So if I press Shift A, we go UV sphere and it places in right in the center. I'll move it over to the right and we can see it's right there in this collection. Now to add in a new collection, which would be just to add in a new layer, we can right click and click new, or if we want to move this UV sphere to a new collection, we can hit the M key and click on collection, or we can click on the new. So if we click new, we can name this collection, we'll just call it UV sphere, and then hit okay. And there we can see we have a new collection with the UV sphere in there. Now to turn these off and on so we can only see one collection, we can toggle the eye icon right there. This one also does the same thing, but it disables it. It doesn't just hide it, it actually disables it. And then of course we have the turn off in the rendered view. So if we turn that off, if we rendered this image, you wouldn't see the UV sphere. We can also double click on the collections and name this. So we'll just call this one main since it has all of our main objects. Another thing that you can do to organize your collections is hit the minus and plus key. So let's say I have a ton of collections and there are many different objects. To just close all of them together, I can hit the minus key and it will close everything together. If I hit the plus key a couple times, it will open every single collection up. Just like that. Now the great thing about collections is you can append a different blend file that has a collection into your current scene. So to do that, you can go up to File and then click on Append or Link. Append will append it in and then it's in this blend file. Link it will only link in the object. So I'm going to append it. So I'm going to click on this. And here we have the blend file that I'm going to be using. We can see it right here, this couch model. If I click on collections, we can see there's a couple different collections right here. And if I click on sofa, append from library, it'll take that collection that has all of the objects in it and then put it into our scene. And then we can see here underneath our main collection that there's a new collection called sofa. If I open that up, we can see all of the different objects in this model. There we go. So I'm going to go into wireframe, just box select that, deselect this, and then delete it. So that's one thing that you can do with collections is append it into different blend files. Now, to move objects to a different collection, let's say I want to move this cube to the UV sphere one, all I have to do is click and then drag it into the UV sphere, and then you can see it right there. Or another way to do that is just hit the M key and then click on whichever one I want to move it to. And let's say we have a collection in a collection, as we can see here, I can move it to the sofa one, or I can keep it on the main right here, or the UV sphere. So if I click on UV sphere, boom, it moves it to here. Now, another cool thing about collections is it will show you how many objects or how many different things are in that set. So as we can see here underneath the main, we see there's a collection in there. We have a lamp and then we have the camera. Here we have two objects, and as you can see that mesh icon has a little 2 next to it. It shows us that there are two meshes in that collection. Let's see what happens if we add in another camera to this UV sphere. So if I press Shift A, I add in a camera. Then you can see the icon of a camera appears right next to the mesh. Let's actually move this to the main collection. So I'm going to press the M key and click on main and then click main right here. And then you can see the camera icon has a 2 next to it. So this is really awesome, and it will tell you exactly what is in your collection. You don't have to try to figure out all of the different objects. You can just look right next to the name and see, okay, I have a collection in there, I have a lamp, and then I have two cameras. You can also move selections to different selections. So this sofa model, there's nothing in it currently, but if I grab it and move it to UV sphere, it'll place it inside here. If I drag it and then place it underneath the scene collection, it'll move it to its own collection set. To delete one, all you have to do is just right click on it, click delete, or just hit the delete key and it will get rid of that. So if we come over to this object data panel, we can see that there's a collections panel right here. This allows you to move one object to multiple selections. So if we click on this, we can see it's currently added to the UV sphere. If I hit click add to collection, I can select main. And now this object is in both the main and the UV sphere collection, as you can see here. I can double click on the name and just type in a different word. So if I just go mesh and enter mesh bracket, we can see that it's right there as well. One thing to note is if you delete a collection with a mesh in it, that mesh will automatically go into your main selection, your scene selection. But if you come over to the collections panel and you get rid of these two groups, it'll delete the mesh. I don't know if that is just a bug or if that's intentional, but keep in mind, if you get rid of these ones over here, it'll delete the mesh. But if you delete it in the properties panel, it'll keep it in your scene selection, in your scene collection, I mean. Also, if you add in different things into your collection, let's say if we add in a mesh and then curve, we can see the icon of the curve right next to the mesh as well. Let's try a empty. We'll see if that anything pops up there. And as you can see, there is an empty object right here, which is pretty cool. And so you know that in this collection, we have an empty, we have two meshes and a curve. If we add in an armature, and as we can see here, we see that there's an armature on this collection. If we open it up, we can see everything. Again, if you hit the plus sign, you can see more details. If you hit the minus key, it'll close everything off. And you can have as many collections as you want. So if I just keep hitting new, we can see more and more collections are being added. Then right here, we can see the shortcuts, which is show one level. It'll show the levels here. And then if I right click, we can go hide one level and it will close it off. And there you go, guys. That is the basics of collections. I will continue to put out more tutorials on 2.8. So make sure you like, comment, and subscribe to see more of that. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next tutorial. Take care. Goodbye.